Hello, and welcome to part one of my new Language Reactor series. The detailed videos are designed for people just starting out. If you're new to Language Reactor, it's a fantastic tool that enhances your language learning experience using native materials. While it's famous for allowing you to watch dual subtitles on YouTube and Netflix, Language Reactor offers so much more. Here are some of the features that you might not have known about. You can explore TurtleTube and select content based on your language level. Read imported books and websites with dual subtitles. Access government courses. Chat with AI. Save and export words and phrases to formats like ANCI. Enhance your vocabulary, listening skills, and grammar with pump phrase. And receive suggestions on which vocabulary to learn next. Join me as we explore the exciting features and benefits of this tool. I've divided the series into multiple videos for easier digestion. Timestamps are provided below so you can jump to the sections of the video that interest you most. Today, we'll begin by installing the extension. Next, we'll customize it to enhance your learning experience with personalized settings, and we'll begin exploring the media section. Let's get started. Currently, Language Reactor is only available through their website and as a Chrome extension. However, Reddit users have successfully installed it on Microsoft Edge, and the developers are working on official extensions for Edge and Firefox, so look out for those. There's no official mobile version of Language Reactor yet, but Reddit users have found workarounds. For solutions, try searching "Use Language Reactor on Mobile" on Reddit. Although you can use LanguageReactor.com without installing the Chrome extension, we'll install it as we'll be exploring it later in this series. I'm already on the Chrome extension installation page. I'll provide a link for you below. Simply click on Add to Chrome, and then on Add Extension. This will automatically open up LanguageReactor.com. In this tutorial, I'll be using the free version. If you're interested in the paid version, pause the video now so that you can see current pricing and the extra benefits. To begin using LanguageReactor.com, please sign in with your Google account. If you don't have one, you can sign up using the link below the video. Unfortunately, this is the only sign-in method supported. I'll sign in now. Whoa, that was fast. Click on Language Settings. Then, select the language you're learning and the language you'd like translations to appear in. I'm learning Chinese. Then click Switch Language. You can also adjust the languages from the Settings menu. Let's go there now. See the language settings at the top? Beneath that is Show Transliteration. Transliteration is when you write the words of a language using the alphabet of another language. This is what pinyin is when it comes to Chinese. I'm not literate in Chinese, so pinyin is incredibly helpful. Here, select the option that best suits your learning style. You can hide transliterations, show them alongside the original text, show the transliterations only, or always show them. Next, choose whether or not you want to hide the subtitles. Currently, this feature is disabled. This means both sets of subtitles, the language I'm studying, and the translation will appear on the videos I watch. Let's see the other options we have here by clicking on it. You can choose to hide the translations or hide the subtitles. Here, subtitles refer to the language you're studying. You can also choose to display the translation first, followed by the subtitle, or vice versa. Next up is translation visibility. Decide whether you want to always display them, hide them for known words, or hide them for marked and known words. So what are known and marked words? Simply put, known refers to words you already know, and marked refers to words you want to learn. I'll demonstrate how to mark words as either known or marked to learn later in the video. Now let's set our vocabulary level. I'll click on it. If you're just starting out and haven't learned any words yet, select I don't know any words yet at the top. Below this, you'll see groups of 6 words each, organized by increasing difficulty. If you have already learned some words, review the list and choose the last group where you understand all the words. I'll pick a group as an example. On the right, you can choose to show known words in green and darken rare words. This color coding can be particularly helpful for many users. When you're finished, click Set Vocabulary Level. One issue I've encountered with the Set Vocabulary Level feature is that despite being signed in, Language Reactor frequently forgets my level, requiring me to reset it over and over again. If you expect this, perhaps it won't be as annoying to you. Now, let's discuss word colors. First up is the Reset button. You can use it to revert the color coding to its default settings. By default, Mark to Learn and Don't Learn are enabled, while all other settings are disabled. As shown, both known words and special words are highlighted in green. Currently, known words is enabled and special words is disabled. Known words are those you mark yourself, while special words include names, countries, and numbers. You can activate both, but since they each use green, it's best to choose one based on your learning preferences. Now let's focus on suggested words and Mark to Learn, both highlighted in orange. It's practical to enable one and disable the other, though you can enable both if you prefer. Suggested words recommends frequently used words for you to learn, while Mark to Learn are words you mark yourself, as demonstrated later in the video. You can also choose to outline Mark to Learn words to emphasize them. In purple, we have Don't Learn, which is exactly the same as Darken Rare Words, which we saw earlier when we set our vocabulary level. Despite the different names used, both options serve the very same purpose. If you prefer not to use the coloring system, you can disable all word color options at any time. Next is the Suggested to Known Words Ratio, which customizes your learning experience by balancing new words and those you already know. Adjusting this ratio controls the difficulty and volume of new vocabulary, making your learning more effective and personalized to your current knowledge level. Next, let's toggle on Show Tags in Text. Now, let's visit the Media section so you can see what tags look like. Tags are the colored underlines you see under some of the words. Tags can be used to create organized lists. For example, you might want to mark all verbs in yellow. We'll see how to mark words with tags a bit later. For now, let's head back to the settings menu. While tags can be useful, they can also clutter the screen. When your screen feels overwhelmed by tags, just toggle off the Show Tags in Text setting. I'll do that now. Next is the Show Learning Stage buttons on mouse hover setting. This feature controls the Mark as Known and Mark as Learning buttons that appear when you hover over a word. Currently, I have the setting enabled. Let's briefly head back to the Media section to demonstrate how to use these learning buttons. When I hover over a word, this box appears. Use the green Mark as Learned checkmark when you want to mark a word you've committed to memory. To mark words you want to learn, use the orange Mark as Learning button. Now let's head back to the settings screen. Let's turn off the Show Learning Stage button setting and return to the Media section to see the changes. Now, when I hover over a word, the Learning Stage buttons no longer appear. You don't see the green check mark or the orange button anymore, right? Let's return to the settings screen. I'll turn the Learning Stage buttons back on. Next, you can choose what happens when you right-click on a word. Either switch known or learning or switch tags. I've selected switch known or learning. Let's return to the Media section to see how this works. Focus on the word yong at the top. If I right-click on it, it becomes green, indicating a known word. Right-clicking again changes it to mark to learn. Let's return to the settings screen. Now, let's change on right-click to switch tags. This setting will not work properly unless you enable Show Tags in Text here. Now we can mark words with tags as we learned by right-clicking. Let's switch to the media section briefly to see this in action. I'm going to right-click on Yong and see what happens. There is a green tag. I can right-click it again, and it switches to yellow. To choose blue or red tags, click on the word you want to tag. I'll click on Na, and then I'll choose red. And now Na is marked with a red tag. Let's return to the settings screen now. Next, you can decide if you want the mini dictionary to appear and the words pronounced when you click on a word. I have both options enabled. Let's switch to the media section once again to see this in action. If I click on Juga, it pronounces the word. As you heard, however, robotic voices are used, so pronunciation can be a bit off at times. If I hover over the word Juga, you can see the mini dictionary just above the word. If I were to turn the mini dictionary off in settings, it would not appear here. Let's head on back to settings now. Next up is My Dictionary URLs. This feature allows you to add your own dictionaries to Language Reactor. We'll discuss this feature in detail in part 2 of this series, available now on my channel. Finally, here in Settings, you can change the language of the user interface. For example, we're viewing the settings in English, but if you prefer, you can switch to another language. Well, folks, that's all for part 1 of our series. I hope you'll join me now in part 2. See you there.